Government data show inflation slowed in August after two straight months of acceleration. The August inflation rate of 2.4% was below the Philippine Central Bank's forecast range of 2.5 to 3.3% and market expectations of around 2.7%. This brought the year-to-date inflation average to 2.5%. A slowdown in fish and meat inflation across the Philippines helped bring down the overall inflation rate. This chart shows fruit inflation also trended lower, while vegetable inflation turned negative, which means vegetable prices actually went down in the marketplace. Rice prices, meanwhile, stayed negative for a 16th straight month, thanks to the continuing effects of the rice tariffication law. But because of tough circumstances brought about by COVID-19 and various quarantines, consumers say they didn't feel the slowdown in inflation in August.
Kahit nang sabihin mo, wala naman akong tao narinig na okay siya eh. Lahat nagsasabi, hirap sila, hindi kaya. Abunado pa, nangungutang pa minsan eh. Dalawa lang kami, mag-asawa lang kami. Sa gamot lang, tsaka yung sa pagkain, wala na.
Hindi na po kasi normal yung trabaho. Kumbaga yung schedule niya, hindi na katulad ng dati, na araw-araw may pasok. Kaya yung allowance, hindi na siya ganun sapat. Para sa pang araw-araw, tapos nangungupahan pa, ganun. So hindi talaga sasapat.
The Philippines' August inflation rate is relatively high compared to major ASEAN economies. This chart shows only Vietnam, shown in green, has a higher inflation rate compared to the Philippines. Negative inflation was seen in Thailand, Malaysia, and Singapore, shown in blue, orange, and yellow. Negative inflation or deflation implies market prices are actually going down. But that would not be an ideal situation as it signals a combination of weak demand and sliding prices that make it difficult for businesses to survive. This typically leads to less investment and even layoffs. BPI lead economist June Neri says it is possible the dip in inflation in August is a sign of weakening demand, but he linked it to the modified enhanced community quarantine, which was enforced in the National Capital Region and surrounding provinces for 15 days. National statistician Undersecretary Dennis Mapa, however, says there isn't enough data to conclude demand is going down.
Ang effect nung ating lockdown briefly nung August, wala naman kami nakitang pagkakaiba sa direksyon ng mga presyo, particular sa pagkain, kasi sa tracking namin sa week on week ay hindi naman nagkaroon ng shock o spike sa food items. The reduction in prices ngayon from our field offices is that it seems to be because there is enough supply. However, if you are looking at the expenditure patterns, household demand, ay makukuha natin yon pag nagkaroon na tayo next year pa nga lang.
Acting Socio-Economic Planning Secretary Carl Chua says in order to maintain stable food supply and protect Filipinos from erratic inflation caused by lockdown, government and the private sector need to tap local agri produce and maximize digital tech. He is calling for more investments in cold storage facilities, innovations in food packaging and processing, and more agricultural investment overall to ensure inflation remains stable nationwide beyond the pandemic. Warren de Guzman, ABS-CBN News.